My dear sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus came into the district of Judea and across the Jordan. Again, crowds gathered around him, and as was his custom, he again taught them. The Pharisees approached Jesus and said, "Is it lawful for a husband to divorce his wife?" They were testing Jesus. Jesus said to them in reply, "What did Moses command you?" They replied, "Moses permitted a husband to write a bill of divorce and dismiss her." But Jesus told them, "Because of the hardness of your hearts, he wrote you this commandment. But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, no human being must separate." In the house, the disciples again questioned Jesus about this. Jesus said to them, "Whoever divorces his wife and marries another commits adultery against her. And if she divorces her husband and marries another, she commits adultery." My dear friends, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated for a while. Again, my dear sisters and brothers, good evening. We know how important relationship is. They say that if we have meaningful relationships, they give also fulfillment and happiness in our lives. But we also know that relationship is always a task. It is a work in progress. St. John Paul II had said, "Love is never something ready-made, not something merely given to man. It is always at the same time a task which they are set. Love should not be seen as something which, in a sense, never is, but is always only becoming. And what it becomes depends upon the contribution of both persons and the depth of their commitment." Let me repeat the last part. What it becomes depends upon the contribution of both persons and the depth of their commitment. St. John Paul II was very clear in telling us that for a relationship to work, there are two important things. Number one, that both are contributing for the relationship to work. Hindi lang yung isa. Both are contributing for the relationship to work. And second, both are committed in their relationship. Because sometimes I think we want to get more, but the problem is that we only give so little in a relationship. Umaasa tayong marami tayong makukuha sa isang relasyon, pero tayo naman hindi natin ibinibigay ang lahat-lahat sa ating karelasyon. Or sometimes, we want the relationship to work, but only one is serious or committed while the other takes the relationship for granted. Baka yung isa lang ang may gustong maging maayos yung relasyon, pero yung isa naman ay wala sa kanya yung seriousness and commitment. And that is also what we've seen in our first reading today from the letter of St. James. He tells us that there are two important things that we need to possess for a relationship to work. Number one is for us to be patient. For us to be patient. And in our first reading, St. James used the analogy of prophets, wherein he said, "Take as an example of hardship and patience the prophets who spoke in the name of the Lord." Because we know that the mission of the prophet is not that easy. It's always unpopular. because they tell us what we need to do or what we have to change in ourselves. Pero yung prophet, they were very patient and they were very persevering. Why? Because they know that they received that call coming from God. That is why they were not giving up. And in our first reading, we see why prophets were very persevering and patient. Because in our first reading, we were told, the Lord is merciful and shows compassion. They are very patient with people because they know that the Lord is also patient with them. I think sometimes we want the other person to understand us or to be patient on us. But the question is, are we also patient with that person? Baka gusto lang natin tayo ang iniintindi, tayo ang inuunawa, pero hirap nating intindihin at unawain yung ating kapwa. Because without patience, yung relationship will never work. But second, St. James is also telling us, we have to be very truthful. Because if we are truthful, there is no need to swear. Walang dahilan para tayo manumpa o mangako. Because in our first reading, St. James tells us, but above all, my brothers and sisters, do not swear, either by heaven or by earth or with any other oath. But let your yes mean yes and your mean mean no. Because if there are times wherein the other person couldn't believe what we are saying, maybe we also have to ask ourselves why. Maybe because in the past, they had seen some inconsistencies in us. Baka may mga pakakataon, we are not truthful in our words. Baka may mga pakakataon, our words are not consistent with what they see in our actions. Baka sinasabi natin that we are faithful, that we are loving, that we have changed. Pero yung ating actions, kabaligtaran ang ipinapakita. Because if the other person believes in what we are saying, we don't need to swear. Hindi natin kinakailangan manumpa o mangako pa. Bakit? Because at the very beginning, the person believes in what we are saying. Kaya nga ito yung pangalawang mahalaga for a relationship to work. And what is that? To be truthful. Kaya nga ang sabi dyan ni St. James, let your yes mean yes and your no mean no. Parang sinasabi niya, wala nang paligoy-ligoy pa. Bago magsalita, isipin, kaya bang gawin? Kaya sa puro salita, ipakita mismo sa ating kilos o sa ating gawa that we are really committed in our relationship. Kaya ito yung paalaala sa atin, the importance of patience and the importance also of being truthful. But if we look at our gospel, there were some Pharisees also who approached Jesus with a question. They've asked him, is it lawful for a husband to divorce his wife? And we know that this topic is very timely, the issue of divorce. If Jesus only wants to be popular, he will try to avoid answering that question. He will simply keep quiet. But if you notice, when we look at our gospel, the reason why Jesus came is not to please us. The reason why he came is to remind us what pleases God. That's why in our gospel, Jesus asked them, what did Moses command you? Because Jesus is challenging them to look at what happened in the Old Testament. Because they keep on quoting Moses and said to Jesus, Moses permitted a husband to write a bill of divorce and dismiss her. But look at the response of Jesus. He said to them, because of the hardness of your hearts, he wrote you this commandment. Very clear. Jesus was telling them, it was permitted because it's okay, it's good. It was permitted because you were very stubborn, because of the hardness of your hearts. Because if we do not have openness, openness of mind and heart, same thing, relationship will never work. Because sometimes we simply insist on what we want. And if we do not get what we want, we simply surrender and give up. That's why when we look at our gospel, Jesus is inviting us to look at the reason why God had put man and woman together. Hindi para pahirapan yung buhay natin, kung hindi para maging makabuluhan yung buhay natin bilang mga tao. If relationship makes us better persons and makes also our life fruitful. Si Pope Francis, I think, was very clear when he told us that we live in a disposable culture. Disposable culture, he said, that parang lahat ng bagay can simply be disposed, yung throwaway culture. Pwede mong itapon, pwede mong palitan. Napakadali. And he said, sometimes we also do that in our relationships. Parang pati yung ating relasyon sa bawat isa, madaling itapon, madaling palitan, madaling ayawan. Maybe we also have to ask ourselves, if relationship is disposable to us, what is the thing that really matters to us? Ano ba talaga yung ating pinanghahawakan? Ano pa yung pinakamahalaga sa ating buhay? Kung mismong relasyon, kung mismong yung ating ugnayan sa bawat isa, ay hirap nating ipaglaban at hirap nating panindigan. I think looking at our readings, we see that there are three important things that we need to remember for our relationship to work. Number one, be patient. Pag sinasabi nating patient, hindi lamang pinagtsatsagaan natin ang bawat isa. When we say patient, we are not giving up on someone. Why? Because we are still hopeful that the person would change and would become better. Second, for us to become truthful, let our yes mean yes and our no mean no. Baka nawawala yung trust because may mga pagkakataon hindi tayo truthful in our words. There is inconsistency between what we say and what they see in us. And number three, be open. Because looking at our gospel, Jesus is telling us that it was permitted by Moses not because it's okay, but because of our stubbornness. Because we keep on insisting on what we want. Magandang ating tignan, not simply on what we want, but on what God wants. Because most of the time, when we think of what we want, we always choose what is comfortable for us. But if we look at what God wants, definitely, it is what is best for us. Tignan natin ano yung ating laging pinipili, yung gusto ba natin o yung gusto ng Panginoon para sa atin. Amen.